Victor liked fixing engines, and he liked being busy. And today was a very busy day at the steamworks. Trucks and engines were everywhere.
Hurry up with those valves. We don't have all day, you know.
Percy was waiting to be painted.
I'd like to be gleaming and green, please, Victor.
And Edward had to be fixed.
My broken boiler is bothering me, Victor.
Victor clickety-clacked along the tracks from one engine to another.
I know, my friends. You all need to be fixed, and you all want to be fixed right away. But I only have one set of wheels, you know.
As the engines approached the Earl's estate, they saw new rails and wooden sleepers, stone and building materials. Then Thomas saw his old friend Jack, the front loader.
Jack, what are you doing here?
Hello, Thomas. I'm helping the Earl with his new building project. He's restoring Ulstead Castle.
Fizzling fireboxes.
So that's what he's building.
Wow.
I'd better get back to my job. There's still a lot of work to do.
As Henry whistled from the other platform, Percy mistook a man waving a green handkerchief for the guard waving his flag. And Percy set off.
Too soon. Stop! You're not unloaded yet!
Percy had to wait while all the letters were recovered.
Oh, Percy, that's bad luck.
That's not bad luck, is it, Ben? Quite right, Bill. That's carelessness.
Oh, now I'm running late.
A smooth ride. Sir Handel is one of the oldest engines on the island of Sodor. He's a dark blue colour and has a small number 3 painted on his side. Sir Handel is also known as one of the smoothest engines on the Thin Controllers Railway. Sir Handel had been working in the stone quarry all summer. The Thin Controller, Mr. Percival, was happy to see him back.
I've got a special for you, Mr. Percival told Sir Handel. I want you to collect some trucks of apples. You must pull them very carefully or the apples will bruise.
Yes, sir, whooshed Sir Handel, and off he chuffed.
It was almost Christmas, and the tracks had become very icy.
Whoa!
The fields and trees were covered in snow, and there was ice on the pond. But none of that was of any concern to Terence. Terence is a crawler tractor with caterpillar tracks instead of wheels. He was working with the woodsmen. They were cutting down trees to take to Tidmouth for the Christmas market.
Hi, Terence.
Hello, Thomas.
Are these all my trees?
We're just collecting a few more. Won't be long now. I see you're wearing your snowplow.
Well, it's very snowy out here. Not that you've ever been bothered by snow and ice. Your caterpillar tracks are proving as useful as ever.
Oh, now they're useful, eh? You didn't seem to think so when we first met.
You'll be laughing on the other side of your boilers soon, silly steamies. Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, engines and excavators, I am very proud to open this new branch line, taking my railway up to Harwich for the very first time. My new tank engine, Ryan,
will take care of the goods traffic, and I'll be calling on a very special friend to look after all the passengers.
But, sir, I already have a branch line.
Not you, Thomas. I was referring to Daisy, the diesel rail car.
Daisy?
That's right, Thomas. Me!
So, without further ado, I declare this branch line open!
He reversed quickly down Thomas's line. But he found Douglas blocking his way.
Out of my way, Huff Gordon. I've got an important passenger to collect.
You can't get past, puffed Douglas. I can only go back as far as the next station, then Donald is in the way. Gordon felt terrible. All the engines were stuck, and it was all his fault. How can I collect the engineer? He puffed. Then Gordon had an idea. Maybe all the engines can help, he thought. Gordon told Douglas his idea. Then Douglas puffed down the track to tell Donald. What a grand plan, chuffed Donald.
Emily came to the top of the hill. The tree rolled away. And Emily raced down the other side. Emily met Duck at a junction.
Trevor's waiting for you.
Don't worry, I'll be there soon.
Some of the tracks ahead are very muddy. If you get stuck in the mud, it's going to take you even longer.
I'm excellent, Emily, and I know which tracks to choose.
Duck was worried.
I'm really sorry, sir. I was trying to help Bertie's passengers, but it got a bit out of control.
A bit?
I'll say.
Then you'll be pleased to know I've made other arrangements to help Bertie's passengers.
Bertie? He's back!
No, Thomas, he isn't.
Bulgy! But I thought you'd been turned into a hen house.
Only for a while. Then I was a mobile vegetable stand. And now I'm back in service. And if you don't mind my saying so, we'd all be better off if everyone simply used roads instead of railways.
Now, Bulgy, don't go getting all anti-rail again, or I might find some chickens who need a place to live.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
And now that you don't have to worry about Bertie's passengers, I'll expect you to be bang on time for the rest of the day, Thomas.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir.
Cheerio.
I don't suppose you fancy a race back to Knapford?
What? I certainly do not. Down with railways!